Early detection of cancerous lesion is very much important for good prognosis. There are various methods of early detection of cancerous lesion. Today, we'll discuss about toluidine blue staining procedure for early detection of cancerous lesion. Toluidine blue can be used in two forms. It is either applied to the site of the lesion with a cotton applicator, or it is used as mouth ring. Let's come to the procedure part. First, you have to examine the oral tissue properly, floor of the mouth, buccal tissue, both sides, lip, tongue, hard palate, soft palate. You have to examine all the mucosal tissue inside oral cavity. Then if you think there is any suspicious lesion, any suspicious area that can be a pre-malignant lesion or a potential cancerous lesion, then you have to think about the proper diagnosis. Or if you are seeing a obvious ulcer or any lesion, pre-existing lesion, for the diagnosis part you can do toluidine blue staining procedure. After examination, if you think it needs toluidine blue staining procedure, then you have to tell the patient to rinse mouth twice with water for 20 seconds to remove the debris. Then application of 1% acetic acid for 20 seconds to remove any ropey saliva. Then application of 1% toluidine blue solution for 20 seconds either with cotton swab when a mucosal lesion is seen, or given as a ring when no obvious lesion is detected. In this diagram, in this photo, you can see application of toluidine blue solution to a specific mucosal lesion with cotton swab. Now the staining is done. Next, application of 1% acetic acid to reduce the extent of mechanically retained stain. So when you are try to stain an area, there are two way to retain the stain. One is mechanical, or one is due to any alteration of the tissue. So we need the stain to be retained to a altered tissue, not mechanically. So you have to remove the extra stain that is mechanically retained, that is by application of 1% acetic acid. So you can see we're using cotton swab for reducing the extent of mechanically retained stain. Now rinsing oral cavity with water, oral examination and recording to the stained areas. You have to see if it is dark stained or pale stained or no staining at all. So next part is interpretation. Now the interpretation part. A dark blue stain of either the entire lesion or a portion of it is considered as positive stain, then lack of color absorption by the lesion as negative stain, and light or pale blue staining as doubtful. So you can get from the staining procedure a dark blue area or pale blue area or no color, no staining at all. Masberg suggests some areas not to be considered positive if it retains stain. These areas include the nucleated scales covering the papilla of the dorsum of the tongue, pores of the seromucinous glands in the hard palate, dental plaques, gingival margins around each tooth, diffuse stain of soft palate transferred from the retained stain on dorsum of tongue, and ulceration lesions. So these areas, it is not considered as positive if it retains stain. Next, confusion prevails over the interpretation of pale colored staining. Some recommend rewiping of the lesion with cotton swab dipped in 1% acetic acid. If the staining disappears, it indicates a negative result, and if it persists, it indicates biopsy. That means if you are finding a pale lesion, that is doubtful lesions, you have to rewiping the lesion with cotton swab dipped in 1% acetic acid. Then also, if the stain is retained, it needs biopsy. So if dark stain, then it is a positive, you have to go for biopsy. Then if it is pale, it is doubtful, you have to rewipe the area. If color retains, then you have to go for biopsy. And if there is no color absorption, there is no need for biopsy, but you have to follow up obviously. So this toluidine blue staining is a simple, quick, non-invasive and highly cost-effective procedure. It is used as an adjunctive aid in the detection of pre-malignant and malignant lesions in selecting biopsy site, in the screening of the second primaries of the oral cavity, for the detection of multicentric tumors, in obtaining the marginal control of carcinoma, and during the follow-up of treated lesions. Thank you very much for patience listening. See you next video.